Back in the office, an interesting case has landed on Terry's desk.
Oh, this is Clive Parsons. We received an anonymous letter. It suggested that this guy was working as a doorman at a local sports and social club. It also goes on to say that he has entered for election in the last couple of local council elections, 2004-2006.
Anybody who wants to claim DLA has to fill out a 48-page form. Every detail of how their disability affects them must be written down. In some cases, they'll need to provide medical evidence.
This is the actual claim form that Mr. Parsons has completed. He said that he can walk for 20 seconds, 2 yards, it takes him 20 seconds, and he's always like this. He continually has falls. Can only walk with 2 sticks because of his arthritis. Has a problem with stability. Must have somebody with him. He can fall at any time. I've also approached the club, and yes, he does indeed work at the club. Works as a doorman. What I've done a bit of research. I've obtained 2 sets of documents. The first one shows that in May 2006, he stood as Liberal Democratic candidate for the Sutton Park ward, this in Kidderminster. He polled 139 votes and unfortunately came last. I've also got documents from the Liberal Democrats Wyre Forest, their own publication. It actually shows Mr. Parsons out canvassing.
There he is.
Terry decides to see if the allegation about Clive Parsons is right. He's waiting outside his house, keeping an eye on the front door. Fellow investigator Andy Seal is around the corner, ready to follow Clive Parsons if he goes into town.
Lots of movement. Here he comes. What this guy's saying is that I walk with 2 sticks because of arthritis in both legs and hips. Can't get dressed. I wonder who dresses him then, because he lives alone as far as I'm aware. And this is the other clincher. The reason he can't cook a main meal is I would have problems standing to prepare food and coping with hot pans. He's been at that bus stop for, 7-8 minutes now, standing up?
Clive Parsons has walked over 400 metres to the bus stop. Andy is going to get on the bus while Terry follows in the car. Clive Parsons gets almost £90 a week in disability living allowance because he claims his health problems have left him housebound. He's been receiving disability benefits for 28 years. Terry and Andy could not have hoped for more. Clive Parsons has been out for half the day and they've been filming it all.
He's out and about and he's got his sticks, but that's fine. You can walk with your sticks. You can walk, you can walk.
I think we've managed to counter all of the things that he's put in his statement. So, yeah, good day today.
Terry will still have to follow Clive Parsons again to prove that today wasn't just a one-off.
It's 11 o'clock, I'm Anita Arnon, and the ballot papers are piling up in counting halls around the country.
It's the day of the local council elections. If the allegation is true, then candidate Clive Parsons, who says it takes him 20 seconds to walk 2 yards, will be having his big day in the spotlight. Terry's waiting for him to make an appearance.
Well, I could see you got a window at the front and somebody was either, I think, was closing the window. You could see some clear movement. The curtains twitched. So, that along with the smoke coming out the chimney, as far as I'm concerned, I'm satisfied now there's somebody in there.
Oh. Hello.
Andy's parked up the road, ready to lend a hand if they have to follow him.
All right then, thank you. Bye-bye.
There he comes. He's out.
Clive Parsons claims DLA because he says he can't walk, cook, or get dressed without help. According to his claim, it would be dangerous for him to go out alone.
He's just wandering around.
Any sticks?
No, no sticks.
So he's done a little bit of walking with no sticks, and he's out and about, so he could be going somewhere, couldn't he?
Booted and suited, and I think ready to go.
Ready for his day in the public eye.
He's out again. He's got his sticks this time. He knows he's being filmed now. Came out of his house with his suit on, rosette on lapel. Where's he going? He's back now.
Clive Parsons seems to have forgotten something in his house, but luckily for Terry, he also seems to have forgotten to use his walking sticks.
Oh, here he comes out again.
It's going to be down the alleyway. And I don't know where the footpath leads to. I'm just trying to find a route that will get me to where I think he's just come out of. Can't see him now. So he could have gone into any of the houses, could be anywhere.
Clive Parsons has disappeared. The only option is to try and find him at the local polling stations.
Absolute and complete loss. That one's Betty.
Terry has invited local council candidate Clive Parsons in for questioning. As well as DLA, he also claims incapacity benefit because he says his disabilities stop him working. He receives almost £350 a week and he's been claiming since 1979.
Clive, do you want to take your coat off? Because I know it's hot in here. I'm suffering as well and I know what it's like. We might as well get comfortable before we start. We have reason to believe that you may have failed to tell us something that could affect your claim to benefit.
Right.
Can you tell me where you were on the 3rd of May this year? Pretty important date.
I don't know where I was on the 3rd of May, I can't remember.
Well, I'll give you a clue then, Clive. The 3rd of May is the day there were some local elections.
Oh, yes, sorry. I am a member of the Liberal Democrat.
Liberal Democrat Party?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry about that, I forgot.
That's all right. See, I think that for the last three local elections, you've put yourself up for candidacy as a local councillor.
Yes, yes, it might be. Right. Yeah, it might be three.
And I'm sure you'll agree that the role of councillor is a very responsible one, somebody who needs to be mentally agile. You felt yourself more than capable, or certainly capable, of fulfilling the role of councillor to Wye Forest District Council.
Well, I thought I could, I don't know.
Well, on three occasions, you've actually made a formal application to that effect, haven't you? That would suggest to me that you think that you're capable of doing it.
Well, I suppose so, yeah.
OK. I'm going to ask you about another date now. This date is the 28th of April. Were you at the club on Saturday, 28th of April, do you know?
I think I was, yes.
Do you want to tell me about that date? What makes it stick in your mind?
I think there was something gone at the club.
Like a special event?
Yeah.
I was there for about 5.5 hours. You didn't need your sticks. Your legs didn't give way. You were able to sell raffle tickets for 30 minutes and showed none of the symptoms that you're demonstrating today.
You know, sometimes I am like that, and then other times I'm bad.
Yeah.
You know, I'm really bad. I'm not putting it on.
Clive, that's not for me to suggest otherwise. It's going to be entered in evidence anyway.
Next, Terry reads a witness statement from someone who's worked with Clive Parsons for 3 years.
When he arrives at the club, he places his sticks behind the reception desk, then goes to change into his uniform jacket. He does this without help or difficulty. He's a large man, and part of the reason he was employed is because of his physique. I'm not aware that he is physically disabled. He has never suggested he has any physical disabilities. And I said that paints quite a different picture from the one that you've been portraying here today. Do you agree?
Oh, maybe it does, but like I said...
You said maybe it does. It does.
Well, yeah.
No maybe about it.
No.
That's a statement from somebody that's known you for 3 years and has never, in that time, seen you like this today. How can that be?
I don't know.
You okay?
Clive Parsons pleaded guilty to three charges and was sentenced to 12 months in prison.